What do you do at the open of the market? That's a really good question. It even looks like Metro's a little curious. So what I'm gonna show you in this video is exactly what to do at the open of the market, how to trade it, and exactly what I look for. I just wanna say thank you for all the support, guys. I really do appreciate it. Thank you if you've subscribed, if you like my videos, it means a lot. So without further ado, let's get into my computer. Now, I was looking at my analytics and it said that 90% of the people that view my videos are not yet subscribed. So if you haven't subscribed, please hit that button down below for me, and that would mean a lot to me. So one of the first things that I like to do at the open of the market is I like to be present at my computer 15 minutes before I actually start trading. And I'm not gonna sit there an hour, 2 hours before, because you might get anxious and you're like, okay, well, I see a setup, and you might disobey your rules that you have. So obviously you guys have your own rules that you trade with, but with me, I like to be at my trading station 15 minutes before I start trading. Now, one thing that I'm looking at, you guys can see right here, this green box right here is my New York session. So if you guys haven't watched my previous videos, you can go right here and type in session. And then it's this one right here, the session break. So it shows you exactly what session we are in. So this is the New York session right here. So I'd like to overall zoom out of my chart. And you can see this is Asian and London session right here. What I like to look for is what trend are we already in before the open of the market? Because I've noticed this pretty much all the time. If we're already in a downtrend, it's most likely just gonna have more of a bigger push to the downside. If we're in an uptrend, it's most likely gonna have a bigger push to the upside. So we can see before the market opened right here, we were already in a downtrend forming A's, A's, M's. And a lot of the time when you see A's in the market and M formation, that's telling us that we're already in a downtrend. So we could see that we see a lot of A's right here. And this was actually the open of the market. It went up, formed an A, and then dropped down. And this would have been your ideal setup right here. This doji that closed at 6:45 a.m. And then right after that, we get a nice drop. I think it dropped around 1,400 pips, if I'm correct. Yeah, we can see it dropped 1,000 pips in 15 minutes, which is pretty damn crazy. So that's my step one. That's what I like to look for at the open of the market. So step two, we need to make sure we don't get caught in a false breakout. I'm gonna show you a very good example that happened last Tuesday. So if you guys wanna go to a date, instead of scrolling all the way back like that, trying to find a date, you just go right here to this button and then you find it. So last Tuesday was right here after the 4th of July. Okay. All right, perfect. Here's the open of the market. I am looking at the 5 minute chart right here. So we can see that we already were in what? A downtrend. But a lot of people, when they went into the market right here, it's pretty crazy. This is why I'm a lot more patient when I trade the open of the market. But a lot of people, they saw this doji right here. And they're like, okay, perfect. Let's sell. Let's put our stops right here at this red line, right above the wick of that doji. And you guys can see right here that the market makers came out and created a false breakout. So this long pin right here, I want you guys to understand that this pin was once filled. So a lot of people, they might have been short and they got stopped out. And then they're like, okay, well, if we're not selling, we're going into a buy market. Everyone buy, buy, buy. So as this whole body was going up, there was a lot of momentum. It was filled once at one point, completely blue. So everyone's like, okay, buy, 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 buy. And that's what the retail trader does. They're like, okay, let me go with the first reaction that I see. So everyone's loading up buy orders right here. And then what does the market maker do? Boom, snatches it away. So I would assume for the first 1 to 2 minutes, it was loading up on buy orders and then just took the market down and dropped. And that's what a false breakout is. So you guys need to be cautious with these false breakouts, because that's what the market makers do. They want to get all these orders that are pending right here and get people to think that it's going long, and then they're going to go in the opposite direction. So a lot of people got screwed over right there. So one thing that you need to have at the open of the market is patience. Just because it's shooting up real quick doesn't mean that that's the actual move. Here's a golden nugget right here. You guys want to look for the slow and steady move. That's when you know the money is in the market, the big money, I should say. If you see quick moves like that, they're obviously just putting fear into the market and greed. They want people to go the way that it's not really gonna go. So that's step two. Step three, this is a very important step, and it's having a time slot.
So I mentioned in my previous videos that my time slot is 6:30 a.m. PST to 7 a.m. PST. So I have a 30-minute window when I'm sitting in front of the charts. I don't have my phone by me. I'm fully focused and aware on what's going on. And if I don't see a perfect setup, I can't tell you what a perfect setup looks like to me because it might be different for you guys. So you have to kind of identify that with yourselves. Okay, what is my ideal perfect setup? What am I looking for at the open of the market? And go and trade and look for that perfect setup within your time slot. So you could use the same time as me. You could be like, all right, well, I'm gonna give myself 30 minutes to find a setup. And if I don't, then I'm not gonna trade that day. I'm gonna just trade the next day. And I want you guys to really be cautious when you're trading because you shouldn't be trading every day, honestly. When you're trading every day, you're lining the broker's pocket. So if you're taking a loss, who gets your money? The broker. So you guys shouldn't be trading every single day. Have goals that you have put together. Like me, 2,000 pips is my goal. You guys can come up with your own goals, but step three is definitely find your time slot that you're gonna be trading in your ideal perfect setup. So step four, we're gonna set up our trade. So ideally, this is how we do it. We have our time slot, 6:30 to 7 a.m. So this was a pretty big move right here. You guys have to be aware that if there's a big move like that, your stop loss is gonna be above that pin right there. So are you gonna have a stop loss of 1,100 pips? That's pretty damn big. So when we're already in a downtrend, it's most likely gonna form a lower high like it did right here. So I would've waited this candle close at 6:50 a.m. and that's where I would've took my trade. I'm like, all right, we're in a clear downtrend. The false breakout already happened. I think the overall move that's gonna happen is it's gonna be a short. So I would've went short. I would've got my short position, put it right here. Have your stop loss set. I would have my stop loss a little bit above that wick right there. So I'm risking 371 pips. And then I would have had a 2-to-1 risk reward ratio, or I would have targeted a golden zone. And I'm gonna show you guys in a couple videos from now how to set up golden zones. It's super, super important. I think you guys are gonna really love it. So stay tuned. That's another reason to subscribe if you guys haven't already. So 2-to-1 risk reward ratio, 370 times two, that's 740 pips. So I would have gone for 700, like 800 pips, or I would have just targeted previous support right here, this golden zone. So that's probably what I would have done, is target that golden zone for 1500 pips. And you guys can see the replay. Okay, so we have our doji come right here, boom, perfect entry. Put your stops, take your trade market execution for a short. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So within 7 bars, you would have hit your TP. So 7 times 5, like 35 minutes, you would have hit your take profit for 1500 pips, which is pretty damn crazy. So that's what I wanted to go over with you guys in this video. As always, I always recommend that you guys take notes and even maybe take a picture or a video on your phone so you can use it for future references. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button, like this video. And if you have any ideas on videos I should do in the future, let me know below. As always, I appreciate you all. Peace out.